who, if you were sat on the bus, everyone's got one seat, and there's no free seats left, who are you going to sit next to? Besides me.
Besides you.
So Belly, the point of Coffee Club is for the guests to let us know what we've been doing. So off you go.
Yeah, we're in Stellenbosch now. Feels quite ICC tournament-y because everyone's here, there's five teams.
Yeah.
But yeah, what have you been up to? You went to a vineyard. I went to get my nails done, but I failed. They're not looking good.
They look all right.
But they're chipped.
But so Belly always has to match her colours to the kit, but we're wearing red for this tournament.
Yeah, but I'm not a red girl, so we're going blue. Hopefully blue looks nice.
We've been in Pretoria. We've had a few warm-up games over there. We've got a few more here in Stellenbosch before we actually kick off next Saturday. What have you made of it so far?
Yeah, it's been so good. Obviously, we're warm-up games against New Zealand. We went pretty well, I'd say. And then we're playing South Africa tomorrow, so that'll be good, play a different opposition. But yeah, it's been good so far.
Feeling good? Feeling ready?
Yeah, I'm definitely feeling ready. We've still got like another week. It feels like we've been prepping for a while, but yeah, no, I'm excited.
If you had to go for a coffee with someone in the squad, who are your top two picks?
My top two. Wow, obviously you're in my top two. Who else would I take? Oh, I'd take Lozzie. I've been
Lozzie
really enjoying time with Lozzie recently.
Who, if you were sat on the bus, everyone's got one seat and there's no free seats left, who are you going to sit next to? Besides me.
Besides you. Who have I sat next to? This is going to sound like I am a big arsenic, but I really like sitting next to Louis. He's got
really?
He's got so many great stories.
That's how you're getting in the team then.
Yeah, that's the secret. No, he's got to tell me he's not got good stories.
He has got good stories, he does actually.
Yeah.
He'd probably buy you a coffee as well.
I think he'd buy me a coffee.
So, we've had a little bit of time off. We have started this whole thing by saying that we went to a vineyard yesterday. We have been doing lots of cricket though. You feeling ready to go? You feeling like you're up for the 11th?
I think there's been more like ICC stuff. Obviously we went to the event last night, so it's feeling a bit more like we're here for a World Cup. And yeah, I feel ready.
And in terms of ICC welcome events, probably one of the best backdrops that we've ever had.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't been to that many. It was my first one, but it was the top one, yeah.
That leads me into my next question really nicely. So you were part of our travelling reserve squad for the 50 over World Cup last February when we went to New Zealand. What has got you from that reserve squad spot to being in the squad?
Yeah, I think being like the World Cup in New Zealand was amazing, but like being part of the actual squad is like been so good. Like I feel like I'm part of it now. And I guess, well, obviously Anya retired at the end of that World Cup, which did help. But yeah, I just train really hard. New coaches have helped me settle in a little bit more into the squad and the environment. But yeah, I guess I've just worked hard.
And Anya retiring, was that the moment that you thought I could go for that spot? Was there like a moment that flipped your mindset?
Yeah, because I think like even like over the winter and like when I got picked for the World Cup, it was such a shock. And like even when I was there, I still felt quite a long way off. And I didn't really like I was there obviously, but I didn't really think that I was that close to playing for England. And then Anya retired, and I was like, if I work really hard here, there's a place to get. Whereas when Anya and Catherine were opening bowling, it was going to be tough to knock them off their what they do really. So I guess when she retired, I was like, so I work really hard here, there's a bit of an opening.
And it's been amazing, especially being an old bird in the squad now. It's been amazing for the youngsters to come in and give us that youth and exuberance and all the fun, and literally seeing you smiling like that every day when you come to trip. Well, not every day, we know we're some bad
not
days.
Every day.
But it's been amazing to be a part of that. So wishing you the best of luck for the World Cup. Fingers crossed we can bring it home.